In the material, we saw three distinct components to the value stream map. The first is the information flow. That's the top third of the value stream map. In the center third, there's the material flow, otherwise known as fulfillment. And in the bottom third, there's the lead time calculation or the lead time ladder. Let's look at each of these now individually. The first is the information flow. Pay attention to the information flow when you construct your value stream map, because knowing how information flows tells us a lot about how product does or doesn't flow through the organization. And with today's modern communication mechanisms, email and texting and this sort of thing, information doesn't flow easily, although it may seem with the technology we have. But in terms of production and communicating to production and operators in production, it really isn't a great means of communicating, and communication has a tendency to break down. So by paying attention to this part of the value stream when you construct it, may point to opportunities for improvement. In the fulfillment side or the material flow side, remember back in the mapping module, we talked about doing a high-level process map. And back then, I said there were a number of areas where we'd use a high-level process map. Well, this is one of them. And notice there's five process steps here. So some number, some single digit is a good rule of thumb in terms of representing the value stream map. Now, obviously, that won't cover everything. Try and stay away from parallel flows if you can on the value stream map, although they're certainly acceptable. They're just a little harder to see and manage. But some single digit of process steps representing a high-level process map is what you would use here. Data collected at each process step might include, for example, cycle time, changeover time, uptime, rework time, defects, and this kind of thing. And the idea here is to capture information that will be relevant to the big why you're trying to address or trying to improve. And then finally, in the lower third, we have the lead time calculation of the lead time ladder. So this is very straightforward. Each of the cycle times are represented by the lower part of the ladder, and each of the queue times are represented by the upper part of the ladder. So 5 days on the left here, 5 days is a queue time, and then 7.6 days, those are all queue times. And notice if we sum those up off onto the right, that the customer will see something on the order of about 24 days, and yet it only takes 188 seconds in production to actually manufacture. And the difference, of course, is probably some form of non-value added. And speaking of value added, as you'll see here and throughout the program, we've got three types. There's value added, non-value added, and then non-value added but necessary because of maybe regulatory requirements or that sort of thing. I am not a fan of the notion of business value added. It is something that may be valuable to the organization, but if we took that to the extreme and only did business value added type activities, you know, we'd really be out of business. And so when you're thinking about an activity and whether it adds value, ask whether or not it's something that's valuable to the customer. So the customer is really and ultimately the one that specifies value and not the organization per se. It is very common to find 50 to 90% of all activities that would be waste. They're wasteful, and I've done many value stream maps, and this has proved to be true over and over again. Most of what's done in a typical organization is not value added. It is not billable to a client or invoiced to a customer. It is costing the organization money and represents really just a waste. And so what we're trying to do is to eliminate or minimize as much of that as we possibly can. The current state value stream map then has the information flow, the fulfillment or the material flow, and then the lead time calculation. So this is a completed current state value stream map, and it should be fairly self-evident from this where the opportunities are. And of course, you have to ask the question, what is my big why? What is it I'm trying to affect? If you're constructing a value stream map, it's probably something to do with time. And so then we now have a representation of where the time is being consumed, and the time we're interested in is the time the customer sees, which is typically the lead time. The future state map, now that we have some mechanism to prioritize the opportunities, we want to be able to represent those on a future state map. Part of our job as belts, we need to communicate to the leadership and management what the impact of Initiative A and Initiative B and Initiative C, or Improvement A, B, and C, will have. So we need to quantify those, and we can quantify those by making some assumptions around if we go into a given area and we conduct an improvement project of some kind, how much time can we remove out of the process. And so we can represent those on the future state map, and we do that with these starbursts. And the last thing I'd like to point out is, notice in this slide how the information going from current state to, you know, the second improvement cycle or third improvement cycle, whatever it happens to be, but notice how there's far less information flow. The process is constructed such that every step knows what the next step needs and requests from the upstream process, and there's no need for any intervention on behalf of people or scheduling people or production coordinators of any kind. The process flows through the organization. So that's one thing. And also notice between the first and second improvement cycle, in the first improvement cycle, between each step, there's that little funny looking symbol that's actually a supermarket of sorts. And so we, when we're not entirely have fine-tuned the process, we have supermarkets to cater for variation in the demand through each of the process steps. But notice down in the second improvement cycle, those have disappeared, and we now actually pull. So the customer places an order, and all product is subsequently pulled from upstream processes. So that is the value stream map. It's an extremely valuable tool. You will construct a value stream map in most of your projects, and certainly all of your lean focused projects.